Hi, Mama Shan here with a tutorial to show you a beauty retouch utilizing some of the actions from Mama Shan's Fab Foundations. So the first thing I'm going to do is select my airbrush. Make sure that it is an airbrush. A hard brush does not give the same measurements as an airbrush, and you want to use your left or right bracket keys to get it at the size of the iris, utilizing the Madam's measurement system. And that says 200 up here in the top options bar. So I want to target a Madam's number that is close to 200, and there is one that is exactly 200. So I'm going to click on that button to run the Fab Foundation. Click continue. Get your airbrush a bigger size. Opacity and flow at 100% in normal mode, and just start painting over the skin. Let's flip back to layers. It's created a group with a mask, and you're revealing the foundation by painting with white in the desired areas. Get all of the skin, and then you can kill any overspray by pressing your X key to switch the foreground to black. Get your brush a little bit smaller for killing the overspray. Go over the eyes and the eyebrows, any area under here. Switch the X key if you need to put a little bit more on in an area. And once you've got it to how you like it, then we're going to zoom in a bit and see if there's any blemishes we want to remove. We'll remove those blemishes by opening up the group set and clicking on the gray rectangle. And I'll get my patch tool, and we can move these textures around to minimize any leftover blemishes. There's a lot less work doing it this way than starting out with cloning or patch tool, because the action takes care of so much of it. But if you prefer to do it that way, that's fine too. Okay, that looks pretty good. See, tiny little hairs to watch for above the lip. We need to move that to a spot. Doesn't have any. There we go. Make sure you deselect. Okay, now I'm going to collapse this group and run the Fab Fidelity. This is a sharpening action that also creates a group set. Now, when an action result is a group, you can only run that action one time in the layers panel. In other words, I could not run the size 200 Fab Foundation again without it messing up what I have done previously. I don't think there's a reason that you need to do that, but if you did, there's an action in here that does create a composite layer of everything. You could use that and then remove these groups and double run some of them if you needed to. So I'm going to open up the Fidelity group, and notice how that has sharpened some things up here. So it looks pretty beautiful. What I'm going to do is click on the MS Color Fidelity layer, which is a blank layer, to use my airbrush at lower opacity, maybe about 35%, to just go over these little red vessels in the eye. And notice that it's really a gray color, not pure white, so you want to keep the integrity of the eye whites intact, but we don't want the bloodshot vessels. So we're using that blank layer, which is beneath the detail fidelity layer. And we may have to go into that detail layer just to smooth it up a bit. There we go, that looks better. And if we click on this detail layer, we can come over to our swatches and get that middle gray color so that it's in the foreground and just pass over where those lines are. This is a situation where it's part color correction and part texture correction, so we want to take care of that. Okay, I'm going to collapse this and run the subtle light. Zoom out on this so we can kind of look at it. I think I'm going to do some color correction on her forehead as well. And the beautiful thing about this set of actions and these, the subtle light and the subtle drama, is that we can come back in to our fidelity group here and click on the color fidelity, and I'm going to create a new blank layer right above it so that it's sandwiched between that bottom one that we used and the details fidelity layer. And on this blank layer, I'm just going to call it forehead. So you can correct or add makeup by doing this. And I'm going to make my brush kind of big. 35% is good. I'm going to Alt Option click here. Get that lighter color. Just to even that out a bit. Nice. Okay, I'm going to collapse this, click on my top group here, and run the drama, which looks really nice. So we've got several iterations of this so far. Here's the original, and then here's with just the foundations, and then the fidelity and the subtle light and the subtle drama, which looks very nice. Now on this drama layer, what I'm going to do is highlight that mask, and with black, if I notice when I shut that off that the iris color is a bit brighter, and I think I'm going to bring that back by hiding a bit of the dark drama on the eyes. So I have to conceal that effect. So I need to paint with black on the mask, and then that will brighten up the eyes a bit, just to bring back some of that natural color. Add a little brighter too. And then I'm going to come back to the fidelity layer here and click on the forehead layer and add a new layer. Call it highlights. For this, I'm going to click a light piece of skin here. I may even go white. And I'm just going to back off on this a little bit and do a little bit of brow highlighting here. Just a tad. And I'm going to select this color on the nose right here and just lighten this shadow up a bit. by painting 35% consecutive swipes so that it blends really naturally. Click on this white here, get a tiny, tiny airbrush. I actually should do a new layer for this. Well, I'm still doing highlights, so that's okay. But it doesn't hurt to do a new layer. So just in that dip, so that the lips pop a little bit more, I'm gonna do that. And I'm gonna create another layer for blush. Alt Option click the lip color. Make an airbrush about the size of the apple of the cheek and just start tapping in a little bit of color, a little bit of pink. Come on this side too, a little bit of pink. Come down on the chin, a little bit of pink. Since it's on its own layer, I can lower the opacity a little bit on the forehead. Now I'm going to add another layer, and we're going to do shadow, eyeshadow. And I'm going to go into my color picker and pick a green color. Make my brush a little bit smaller. This I'm gonna put it on pretty strong. And show you another technique for blending. This eye. Just like that. And go up to filter, blur. Gaussian blur. When that dialog box opens up, you want to push it so that you get a nice blend on the edges of the shadow. And then we'll go in and clean up any overspray or add more if we need to. I'm going to click OK. And so for removing this, you could use your eraser, but I find it's more intuitive just to add a mask to it. So click this little white circle in the gray box at the bottom. And so to clean up, put our opacity at 100%, paint with black on the mask. That way if you make a mistake, if you take a little bit too much off, you can bring it back by painting with white. I'm just going to dot that so the lashes come back. Put it out like this. You can also experiment with blending modes on your colors. Let's see what hard light looks like. That kind of blends in very nicely. You can do soft light. That's pretty too. Color. That's nice as well. I like to paint it in normal mode. It gives it a little bit more coverage at the time. I can see what I'm doing better. And then I like to play with the blending modes and the opacity. So I might just take that down to about 71. It just looks great. Next one I'm going to do, maybe make the lips a little bit darker. So I'll add another layer beneath the detail, fidelity. And this one is for lips. And I'm going to Alt Option click on her lip color right there, but then I'm going to click on the foreground color swatch and maybe make it a little bit more vivid, a little darker. Zoom in, maybe just go down to 60%. The nice thing about this technique is that even if you paint over that gloss area, it's not going to completely cover it up because the detail fidelity layer is above this. Then I will experiment with some blending modes. Try hard light and lower the opacity a bit. There's before, there's after. Let's zoom out and see how that looks. There's a couple of ways once you have brushed in like a color, whether it's for the eyes or the lips, that you can change it. There's actually several ways. So you think of this brushing almost as a mask. You can change the color by adding a layer effect to it called color overlay. It's popping up below the recording screen, but it'll open up the layer style dialog box for you. And you can click on this color swatch and then go in and start changing the colors. You know, play with it that way. You can do that with eyeshadows too. Cancel out of that. Another way, let me shut the effects off for here, that you could do this is just do a control or command click on this layer that you put the lips so that you have a selection running, and go under add solid color fill, this black and white circle at the bottom, and let's choose a color, and then we'll change the blending mode of that. Now once we've got that done, we can play with the opacity. We can just simply double click on that color fill and go find another color. Click OK. So I think I'm going to add another blank layer up here. This is going to be some more shadow for the eyes. I'm going to go click, get yellow. Lower the opacity a bit. Filter, blur, Gaussian blur. Gaussian blur is like a sable brush. Just blends things so nicely. I'm gonna lower that, lower this. I think I'm gonna clip this layer to it so that when I lower the opacity, that'll affect it better. Close all these groups up. And on the drama layer, let me open that up. And for this, subtle drama darkener, let me expand this out so you can see it. It's at 25%. So if I wanted to add more darkness to this, I could bring it down like that. If I want more color, saturation, and contrast, I can bring the opacity of this layer up so that we get a very definite look here. Then I can shut this off and we can see how the makeup layers look on the lighter skin one too, and the regular. So that's the beauty about these subtle layers, is you can still go back in underneath and change it and get these various effects. So here's a before and an after. Thanks for watching.